Well, last time I was out here, I was in like a blind frenzy, so I'm going to clean up the workbench and we'll be right back. All right, now I can tolerate this work area. All right, so here's what I did. I'm what some people may call a stickler. And those of you who have known me for a long time in my personal life know this to be true about a lot of really random things that don't make a lot of sense when you really get into the weeds of my personality. However, yeah, I don't know why, but somebody like got into the wiring harness and they got like really far back in the wiring harness and they started cutting shit off. So I don't have flasher relay wire in the bucket where it's the bucket, the headlight bucket. And I don't have a handlebar stop switch wire. And I can hear my wife coming, so I'm gonna have to stop talking. I don't hear my wife, I hear my dog being dumb. Hello? Well, normally when I hear voices, they're real. Anyway, so this didn't have a stop switch. I was trying to get basically the whole front end wired up and discovered that I didn't have a flasher relay wire in the main wiring harness. And I didn't have a stop switch wire for the stop switch that I had to buy. I didn't want to just get random wires and whatever color and just splice them on there. If you buy a kit with all these different kind of crazy color wires, they're expensive, one. And two, they don't have like random green wires with yellow stripes on them. So I had a brilliant idea. I bought the ugliest, rattiest, shittiest, used Honda wiring harness, cheapest as well, that I could find. And I'm going to, what do they call it? Cannibalize? What do they call it when you get something to use the parts? It's not, you don't scrap, it's not for scrap. Anyway, so yeah, I bought an old wiring harness, and yeah, the ends were all nasty and gnarly. I tore all the sheathing off of it, and the inside's perfectly fine. And I got my stop switch wire. I got all the gray wire I need. That's what I did. So these are getting nice and organized and put in my nice organizational boxes that I have for my electrical stuff. And I am gonna use this for all my Honda wiring needs. And then next time I need more wire of a certain color, I'm just gonna buy a whole nother $14 wiring harness that absolutely nobody with any common sense would wanna use for their bike. This one was ugly as hell. Yeah, dude was selling it for like $13.99. Send it. So yeah, I tore all the shit off of it, and that's what I'm gonna use to fix literally everything. All right, I know in the last video I said that I was given the wrong tank mount by Common Motor, but actually I ordered the wrong one. I ordered one for a CL175. I don't know why. I just saw CL175 and hit add to cart. I know that I don't have one. I have a CB175. So I have the correct tank mount. It's a lot different. It's exactly what I needed. So I'm gonna put that on right now. Now this is going to make a big difference. Looks like I'm just gonna have to make one little bit of modification. See these bolts here? I'm gonna have to kind of notch out this little section right here. Get this to slide on. All right, so I just took Just took this little cheapo knife here, notched out. Doesn't look too bad. Only took like 5 minutes. Alright, we're going to do a bunch of stuff at once here on the front end of the bike. So I'm going to do new steering bearings and fork seals. While I've got all this disassembled, go ahead and put a new tire, new tube on. I'm also going to be painting the spokes black. I'm going to be taking off these tapered sleeves on the top that go under the original headlight bracket sleeves. They're like these dog ear brackets, they're all in one. I've had to buy the aftermarket brackets that we all know and love to be able to hold a headlight. It did not come with a headlight. I don't know why. I'm gonna take these sleeves off, they're tapered. I don't want brackets that I bought clamped onto this tapered surface anymore. So I'm taking them off. I kinda wanted some like, I kinda want some fork boots. So I'm gonna maybe look into that. Anyway, so it's a lot of stuff at once, but once I finally get the whole front end done and put back together, I will finish the wiring on the front end and we'll be done. And then I can get everything done on the back and we'll have, you know, the brake light, tail light and all that stuff done. But I'll be really happy to get it all done. Because once I get all this front part done, we're around in third base. All right, guess I'm gonna go ahead and get this front tire off. And brake. Alright, test. And we're live. Alright, so now I've got the wheel all cleaned up. I tried to get it as clean as I could. I used one of those SOS pads that's already loaded with cleaner and some of this like iron diffuser, iron converter stuff, iron eraser to kind of clean the rusty spots on the inside, but I'm still going to use some rust remover later on the inside. But anyway, so now I'm going to start the really tedious task of taping off around the spokes before I paint them black. I'm going to use these little paper hole reinforcement tabs that, you know, you use in your notebooks when you were a kid, and go around each spoke with these. And I'm going to tape off the whole wheel. So it's super tedious, but so is replacing all of the spokes with black spokes. So I've never done that before. I don't want to learn anything new anymore on this bike. I've learned plenty. So I'm going to do that. There's 200 of those in that pack, so hopefully that's enough. And then I'll tape off everything, and you guessed it, I'm going to be using Rust-Oleum to paint the spokes black. Hopefully that turns out okay. After that dries, I will put the wheel back up, or I'll put the tire back on, and I'll put the front end back together. We'll be right back. good. All right, we're doing steering bearings. Now, I've been avoiding it. I don't want to do it. Mostly because I don't know which bearings go where. So basically, I'm just going to take it apart, take a peep at what the bearings that are in there look like, take a note of what order they're in, and then replace them with the ones that look similar. Makeup. Hey. Imagine she's homeless. She's homeless. Shimmy, shimmy, yeah, shimmy, yeah.
Like paint on it.
All right, so I'm back out here. Holy crap. I got a lot going on, so I'm out here like one day on the weekend maybe for a couple of hours. So anyway, I've got the whole front end disassembled. No triple tree, no handlebars. Last thing I did was I redid the steering bearings. I replaced the steering bearings. That was cool. Pretty straightforward, pretty easy. Next, I'm going to rebuild the forks. That's gonna be pretty straightforward. Then I gotta start, then I can start putting everything back together, and I'm going to swap the handlebars out. I wanna get these handlebars that rise, have more of a rise to them. So one reason I'm gonna replace the handlebars is because the new handlebars, they're just like tracker handlebars. They have more of a rise to them, and it'll just help me out a little bit with the cable length, because I have stock cables that I bought to replace them, and they're like full length. So they're too long for the handlebars that came on the bike when I bought the bike. They're not stock handlebars. Another reason is I'm going to run the control cables through the handlebars. I'm gonna have to drill holes for that. I do not like having to run everything outside of the handlebars, and it'll clean that stuff up a lot, and it'll help keep everything organized, all the cables organized and stuff. Hopefully putting the shocks back on goes pretty smoothly. They need to be clean. They need to be cleaned up a little bit. There's actually some red paint showing through right here. So I found that interesting. These look straight, right? Like they're not all like bent, right? Okay, so last week I got to come out here for one night and try to get the undercovers off of the forks. I was unsuccessful. They're super hard to get off. Honda changed the design on the forks shortly after they made this design. They're super difficult to get off, so I'm abandoning that. I only wanted to get them off to change the fork seals. There is like a little circle clip way down in there. That I can't get to unless I get these covers off. So this is the progress I made. It's about a quarter inch. And I didn't wanna booger up the cover anymore. So it's just juice isn't worth the squeeze. So basically all I'm gonna do is tap this back into place and I'm just gonna top it off with new fork oil and throw the front end back together because we're done. And now I've got fork seals that maybe can go on something else. Probably nothing I own currently. So where do I start? Penetrating oil. This is not WD-40, people. Okay. Instagram people. I know who you are, California Tom. Buddy. I wasn't using this. I know it's in the shot, but okay. Not using WD-40, people. This is my first rodeo. Well, I mean, it is with this, but whatever. I'm smart, you know, sometimes. Not when it came to whatever the fuck this was. Look at that. My nightmare is over. Okay, I'm gonna not put these back on. Because I don't see what purpose they serve. They're tapered and they make it hard for my headlight brackets to be correct. Because the little dog ear brackets that are stuck on the bike, of course, were not on the bike when I bought it. So I like forced, you know, everybody knows what these are. If I could just drop everything, that'd be cool. All right, so yeah, those are my, everybody knows what these are. These are the little headlight brackets that you buy. And, you know, they're not tapered. I like forced them to work on these. And I don't need to use them, so I don't think I'm gonna put them back on if I don't have to. Don't stop loving me. So you keep on checking my page. A beep. All right, cleaning these off. I've decided I'm not gonna put the ugly things back on. Hey, how about I like get prepared before I start putting things places? What is this? That's not a 12. That's not a 12! Nope. Silly. I'm silly goose. Oh my god. It's, so the thing is, it's like, I know it's here, I just can't see it. So it's like, it's not that I'm unorganized, it's that I'm unorganized. Like, I know that it's here, right here. I know where my stuff is. I just don't know where my stuff is. 12. Get down there. What is wrong with me? Have a seat. It's not going anywhere. So I got my headphones in. It's the solution to my problem. I'm not having the TV on because I was listening to music with the TV, but I'm gonna be singing a lot more in these videos. So buckle up. You guys are gonna, there'll be a happy medium with that. I'll actually play some music over it, or I'll just cut it out when I review this. If only I could let you go. What am I forgetting, y'all? I'm definitely forgetting something. I just wanna stay. All right, we're just gonna put little buddy right there. No, I haven't put fork oil in him in this yet. That is just literally right there right now. Okay, yeah, this is gonna be better for me. Be alone. You know what? People sleep on disco, I feel. I'm into everything, but if it's a good song, it's a good song. You know what I mean? All right. Constructions. Look at this. Look at this. Yep. The one on the right. It just came off. Whatever. Okay, I'm not even gonna replace it. I'm not even gonna redo that fork seal. Don't anybody say anything to me about it. Because I'm not trying to have one fork seal hanging out. You know, like if I can't change both of them, I'm not just have one fork seal. I'm not doing it. One fork seal for a 72 CB175 hanging out forever. Okay. Am I recording? Yeah. Whoops. But I didn't have my washer on there. Okay, little buddy. Just wiggle on in there. Got it. All right. Dang it. All right. I think this is gonna look okay. With off this top part on here. Technically,
I can put the fork oil in.
And then I can put the handlebars on. It's pretty exciting stuff, just getting to bolt everything back on. I got my new handlebars. They're not new. I just had them laying around. But like I said before, they've got like a higher rise to them. So that'll take out some of the extra room on some of these cables, like my throttle cable and brake cable and stuff. But before I do that, I just remembered I do want to actually run some of the, I want to run the controls. Here's the handlebars. I do actually want to run the controls, the control cables through here. So I need to mill that. Not mill. I don't have a mill machine. I need to start drilling and clean all those edges up. But luckily I already had the handlebars and the levers and all the controls, so I just decided, well, you know, why not? Sweet! Okay, that's done. How they look, but I'm not gonna be able to make my own, so this is what I'm going with. I've got this fit on the way I like it, and I'm just gonna go ahead and take these off and draw where I want to cut, and then we're just gonna go at it. See what the inside of this light looks like. So there is a ring, if you can tell. There you go. There's a ring that keeps this glass bulb in here, glass lens. It's right there. All right, so there's this lip right here that comes up. Not a lip, but the ring kind of has like a bump in it. So I'm gonna use, see if I can get under here. I'm trying my best not to break this glass. Ooh. All right. I got it out. All right, pretty simple stuff. So what I'll do is bend this back so I can fit it on the fender the way I want it. And then make sure I got a good ground and everything works just fine. Then I'll paint it with everything else. Cool.